Hi, good afternoon and welcome to Have a Chat. I'm Audrey Lynch with my co-host Judy Loge this afternoon here on another beautiful Monday.
Yes.
In Miramichi.
Beautiful.
We have a great show lined up for you today, a couple amazing guests that we'll get to shortly. But
really
first
great.
Up, we're going to start off with our quote of the day. Now, that was Vero's turn, but unfortunately she's caught with work today.
She had meetings come up and could not get out of them, so she'll be back with us next week.
We're going to hand it over to Judy.
All right, so my quote for today is, talk to yourself at least once a day or you may be missing the opportunity to meet an excellent person.
I've been there, met her. She's lovely.
Yes.
She's fantastic.
She has competition.
I talk to her every day now.
No, but it's just, you have to affirm your beliefs and things and say, I am a good person. I feel good about myself. Even if you just stand in the mirror for a moment each morning and look at yourself and say, this is going to be a good day.
Yeah.
Name some positive attributes you may have. I'm going to be smiling today. I'm going to give of my heart today. And then you'll feel confident about yourself.
Well, yeah, and you believe in yourself first.
So pep talk every day.
Yeah.
And if you don't do that, you're missing out on meeting a wonderful person.
And you can do that
person.
In your head and out loud. And
not out loud so much,
they
might carry
you
away.
In public, out loud might be a little different. Get a little different take on it if you're caught doing that. But yes, definitely talk to yourself at least once a day.
Pump yourself up.
For sure. Great quote. Also coming up, we want to talk about a little bit, Mother's Day is coming up this Sunday, May the 8th.
My goodness.
Amazing time to get a chance to spend some time with your mom.
Celebrate our moms.
Celebrate, yeah.
And it makes me really, truly sad for those people who are listening that do not have their mothers. My mom lost her mom years ago, and I know that my friend said it's the hardest day for her, even above birthdays and Christmas, because the whole focus on Mother's Day is about her dear mom.
Yes.
It's all about mothers, and where hers is gone, it's a sad time for her.
I don't look forward to that time. I just want to enjoy every single one that I get a chance to, you know, experience from here on in.
With
my mom. I went to go see, my husband and I went, and we had a date night last night.
Nice.
And we went to go see Mother's Day.
Okay.
He bowed down to me because that was my movie of choice. Mm. He would have definitely picked one of the other ones. I wanted something lighter that was funnier, but still something that was touching.
Did you love it?
I did. I really did. Jennifer Aniston, Kate Hudson.
Great.
Julia Roberts.
Wow.
And Jason Sudeikis.
Yes, love him.
Yes, fantastic. So they're four different situations because Jason's wife has actually passed in this movie. So
don't tell
he
me
has,
too much.
No, and he has daughters, and then Jennifer has sons, and then the other two are mothers in different ways.
Mm-hmm.
It's actually really good. It's
well,
all these different scenarios.
We have a date tomorrow night to go.
Oh. Perfect.
So I'm going to take her.
Yeah. It's funny. Stay for the little bloopers at the end.
Yes.
Don't just wait. Yeah, there's a couple of little bloopers at the end, which are quite hilarious. Jennifer Aniston and Jason, actually, they've done The Millers together.
They are good together.
They are really fantastic together.
He's a cutie. He's married to Olivia Wilde.
Yes.
Beautiful couple.
I know. That's
and
just a fantastic movie.
Yeah, so I love my mom.
And if you can talk your mom to going to it, definitely take her.
I'm taking her, and I love you, Mom. And there's nobody I would rather celebrate than myself on Mother's Day, but I think I'll celebrate you this year.
Yes.
No, I don't want anything for Mother's Day. I just want to be with my family and have time together. I don't want any gifts. I don't want any cards. I don't want anything. So if my husband's listening, do not buy me a thing. I have all I need. But I do want to spend quality time with my mother. Maybe we'll do dinner or have her into dinner.
Mm-hmm.
Or if she wants a gift of a special kind, I want to spoil her a bit.
And what's your favorite gift on Mother's Day?
To receive?
Thus far, can you pick one in particular?
You know what? I'm so happy with just a card.
Yes.
A card means a lot to me. The fact that my husband goes out and personally goes through them and picks a card specifically geared towards me and writes his little note on the bottom of it. No, but I'm the mother of his children.
That's right.
So he gets me a beautiful Mother's Day card, like to a wonderful mother, and my kids usually do the same thing. That means so much to me. I have no idea.
Yeah, when they make up their own cards.
I would rather get that than a new wardrobe.
Oh, okay.
No, I would.
No.
A card means more.
I love not having to do all the everyday things that I jump up and do right out of, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
If I don't have to cook and clean that day.
I agree.
And those things happen anyway.
We milk
that's,
it.
That's Mother's Day for me.
I'm going to milk that one too. I'm going to stay in bed all day and be served.
Yes.
That's
there
what
go.
I'll get besides my card.
Yes. So Mother's Day coming up. Don't miss it. Don't forget your mother. For sure. Other things that are happening here in Miramichi, we've got quite a few things. The election's coming up on Monday.
Yes, a week from today.
A week from today, election.
And get out there and vote, people.
Definitely, because stats show only 40% of, isn't that what you told me?
Of 40% this Miramichi
area, actually take the time to go out and vote.
That's
though
sad.
I think the percentage is greater in those who voiced their opinion and how the voting went.
Okay, but 40% is not good enough.
But only 40 of them. No.
I mean, you can't complain about who is in the seat if you don't get out and vote.
No.
You know, and we need these people to represent us. So I went to the debate. It wasn't even a debate.
No,
it was at the Vogue last week. All of the counselors that are running presented themselves, did a platform. Everyone did a great job, I must say. And then the mayoral candidates as well got up and did their platform and took time to explain what they want to do with the city, should they be in the mayor's seat, etc. Had I not gone to that, I wouldn't have had my choices. I actually took a pen.
You have a better idea
now. Spoke, I went tick, 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 tick. And I went over them when I got home and I said, yes, I like the points this person made. I like the points this person made. I agree with that. I disagree with that.
So you can make a uniform decision on who you want to vote for based on what they told you.
Yes, and they gave them enough time. Well, not some people ran out of time, unfortunately, but for the most part, people did have their platforms down pat. Precise information was given, and it really determined how I'm going to vote.
I thought it was great that video was taken of that and posted on Facebook, believe it or not. Gotta love social media. And so I was able to get to listen to and watch some of that as well.
Was that the Rogers debate, though, with the mayors only?
I think there was clips from both.
Okay.
If I'm not mistaken. Okay. I watched the one from Rogers.
Yes, very well done.
But I was able to see that other people that maybe had been there who videotaped the people that they in particular were interested in hearing. Yeah, the counselors themselves. So if there was any one's opinion there that you wanted to hear,
you could get it.
You could get it. You could see it. So that was great for those who
And hats off to all of you running for the election.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a huge undertaking. You're giving up a lot of your lifetime as far as your family, your job. You have to move aside some things, your everyday chores you have to be involved in and obligations. So it's a huge commitment. No, they're doing it for the love and passion of our city.
Exactly. Okay. Exactly.
So good luck, everybody.
So get out there and vote. Okay.
And we'll be aired next week as well.
Yes, Rogers is airing the results as they're coming in.
Yes.
I believe. Next Monday evening.
At 8?
I believe so. Yes.
8 o'clock.
When I get confirmation.
No, it is 8 o'clock.
Okay. Perfect. And what else did we want to talk
about? Well, I have a play to talk about that I'm really excited about.
Okay.
It is coming right up. Double L Productions, that is Lloyd Cameron himself, is producing, directing and producing The Fantastics. Okay, this book and lyrics is by Tom Jones. Do you not love Tom Jones?
I love him.
And the music is by Harvey Schmidt. Okay, this play, The Fantastics, is a love story and it's featuring Katie McDonald and Joey Dignam, as well as Joe Butler.
Okay.
I don't know if people want to see the poster, but it's very nicely done.
There you go.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Details on The Fantastics. Jason Howe's involved in this play as well. Paul McGraw, Cindy Rule, John Bosma, and Gary Blackmore. Again, produced and directed by Lloyd Cameron. The dates are May 13th and 14th at 7:30 p.m., of course, at the Vogue Theater, and May 15th at 2 p.m. Tickets are $20 and are available at Scott's Pharmasave and Brookdale Flower Shop.
There.
So there you go.
Fantastic. If you like to live entertainment, I love going to the movie theater, but nothing beats live entertainment.
I can't wait. And I love Tom Jones. So
The
Fantastics.
Okay. You're not going to want to miss that one either.
Miramichi's finest in here.
The Rotary has something coming up as well here in Miramichi,
The
said?
Rotary, yes. I have to MC the event for the Rotary Club of Chatham this coming Saturday evening. It's on May 7th.
Okay.
It's our annual Rotary Honors and Awards evening.
Oh.
So we do give out the Paul Harris Fellowships.
Right.
And this year the recipients are Bruce Rendell. He's one of our past presidents.
Right.
Ann Woods, 99.3 The River, and one of our great Rotarians as well.
I listen to her and Michelle every morning. They're hilarious.
I know.
I must say, a shout out to Ann and Michelle for putting up with each other by the sounds of it. I don't know who has the worst end of the deal
Ann's a great Rotary member too. So Shannon Summers, she's a stylist, and she does a lot of volunteer work in the community, hospice, and she works with that, and she also raises money, for example, Charlene McIsaac, who is waiting in Toronto all this time for a transplant, lung transplant. She helps do that, for example, the clothes hanger where you donated clothes and then you went in and bought off the rack. She organizes that and much more. So she's a recipient. And Andy Richardson is receiving a Paul Harris. The Vocational Service Award is going this year to Sherry Allison. And we all know Sherry Allison from Big Brothers Big Sisters. So that is at the Rod. And if you want more information or tickets for this event, it's happening again May 7th. And you can call Gina at 773-6406. Or Valerie at 778 9995. Thank you.
Yes. So much happening here in Miramichi. Like, if you really can't find something to do this coming weekend, you're really not looking that hard.
No, no. Just call me. I'll take you everywhere you want to go.
Always so much going on here in Miramichi. We want to announce, so if you haven't heard already, we lost a great resident of Miramichi recently. Hoppy Dunn has passed away.
Hoppy Dunn did. My brother's a sports writer at the Daily Gleaner, Bruce, and he knows from the sports world what a great voice he was for the Miramichi.
He
and
was.
So engaged with it. And everyone, he should have had his name Hoppy. It turned into Happy. He was always happy and exuberant and pumped for the game.
Enthusiastic.
He certainly was. Started way back with the Packers when he was announcing for the Packers hockey team.
Exactly.
And that was back in the 80s.
Yeah.
And we'll sorely miss him. He was a big personality.
Unfortunately,
he was only 52 years old and had various health complications. So we've lost a marvelous person past weekend.
That's just it. I do want to mention I lost a dear friend this past last weekend, a classmate, Michael Ryan, unfortunately was murdered here in Miramichi. Very sad.
It was devastating.
Thoughts and prayers to his son and wife and family. Mm. He had a very large family. And I do want to say that if you haven't heard already, and I'm sure most of Miramichi has, that there has been arrest made in this case. And I know I can't voice too much of an opinion on what I think of the whole crime, but it was very vicious and just makes no sense to me whatsoever.
No.
Why this had to happen, but I'm thankful that our police force, the RCMP, were quick.
I know.
To gather information, to find out who and what it all concerned, and that it's going to go to court and it's going to be looked after and justice will be served and dealt with.
He was a fantastic young man.
He was.
You never saw him that he wasn't smiling, greeting people. He served our city very well. He worked for the power company, didn't he?
Yeah, he worked for the hydro. Yeah, he suffered a tragic accident years ago with an electrocution.
Yes, he did.
He survived that and came back.
Bless his heart. Yeah. He was very young. And well-loved. I couldn't go because I just had to be at another meeting. And unfortunately, they said the lineup to attend his wake
and
give comfort to the family was huge,
which
speaks volumes about the kind of person he was with many loved ones out there grieving his loss. And so, terrible, terrible thing. Again, we don't need that connection of a murder tied to our beautiful Miramichi.
No,
it's just one more devastating thing. We need to be positive, and that's a really big loss.
Yeah, I'm afraid so. So thoughts and prayers again with his family, for sure, at this time. A little tidbit of information you were telling me about out in BC. A little boy had gone missing, was it?
He was
16 hours.
Yes, a two-year-old boy in the Rocky Mountains, you know, in a small little community up in the Rockies, in BC. And can you imagine, they were camping, the family, and they took a family hike.
Right.
And this little boy wandered off, and he was gone for hours. Well, all night the search and rescue was out, helicopters, the dogs, everybody looking for this dear little child. Thankfully, Audrey, he was found. The aunt said it had to be prayers. She said they held a prayer vigil for him the night before. They didn't give up on him. When they found this little boy, Isaac Leuvenberger, only 2 years old, he had many, many scratches on his body, but they said, can you imagine finding your child you thought might have drowned? There's so many little, you know, areas of water around there and everything. What a blessing.
It was. It truly was. Because when I heard there was another little fella missing, I thought, oh, no.
What a beautiful end to that story.
Yeah, it was.
Thank
really
goodness.
Was.
So people can't give up hope. I mean, it's my most terrifying thought.
No.
To see parents lose a child even for a little while, but to go overnight in the dark and all. It's a miracle.
No, exactly. That's just it. So, what do you want to talk about now?
Well, let me see what I want to talk about. I want to talk about my dog. She had her fifth birthday on the weekend.
Her fifth birthday. Okay.
Big party. Big party. Everyone was howling and barking. She's a sweetheart. And I was showing the girls earlier on my phone. We were watching my husband and I a television program last night, just a random show. And there were dogs all throughout it. So my dog was perched on the couch and she was actually watching the action that was on the television featuring these dogs. So she stayed tuned for about 45 minutes.
Oh, you're kidding.
Just
watching
a little person. Hilarious.
Yeah. But her kind were on TV.
It was a mix of dogs. They were lapping and barking and you know, feeding. It was really funny to see that.
No,
but we don't go like some people celebrating big time our dog's birthday. We just love her every day the same.
Yes,
and we, you know, bring her treat on that day and, you know, give her extra love. But some people bake cakes.
Yes, they go all out. Yep. They do. They bake actual special cakes that are actually edible for animals.
Yep.
Yep. There's recipes you can actually find. You can Google all of that stuff. For
sure. I don't do that. Speaking of recipes, do you find with your children, like last night I wanted to have a meal that was nice and I thought pretty healthy.
I'm running out of ideas and recipes, so if you're going to throw me one, please.
Do you like scallops?
I don't do seafood,
okay,
but go ahead.
Okay, well, last night I did scallops, and I just like them a little bit sautéed with a little bit of an oil or butter and lime and just pepper. And then I did a really, really nice salad. And there's a recipe for salad dressing you can either make that contains some lime or you can actually buy one with a zest to it that contains lime as well. So that with the scallops with a little bit of sprinkled fresh lime. And I did zucchini. And what I do with my zucchini is I bake it in the oven.
Okay. You slice it.
Slice it.
And scoop it out.
Yeah, lay it on a tray, spray your pan lightly. And then just when I think it's at the right texture, I take it out and either shave or sprinkle on Parmesan cheese.
Okay.
And it gives it that little bit of a sting.
Okay.
So it's not boring.
No.
And I just put that all together, but my son said, I don't like that. I said, there's the... You know, the kitchen and...
Yep, and there's the fridge.
And there's the car. If you want to go out to get yourself something, see you later.
Yeah, there you go. That's just it. You don't make different meals.
No, I don't.
No, this is what we're having.
This is what we're having. If you don't like it, there are options, but you're going to find them yourself.
No, exactly. That's just it. No, I'm always running out of ideas because I feel like I do the same thing over and over.
I know,
so I
do
love...
Too.
I personally prefer a meal that comes all in one dish.
Okay.
I like it when
stew?
The meat... The potatoes and the vegetable, like whether it's a casserole or anything
else
like that.
I like
it when it all comes in one. I find those very, very easy as opposed to doing everything separate.
But even baked tomatoes in your oven. Again, sprinkle herbs on them or something. Chop them up or dice and then lay them in the tray. And then you can do a little bit of sprinkled cheese over that and herbs. And they come out tasting nice. And they're healthy, tomatoes.
My favorite new one that I just tried was... let me see if I get this right. Spaghetti squash.
Yes, I've had that.
Where you cut that and you butter them and salt them and face down. And I love it.
It's very good.
I couldn't get over it.
Well, there we're coming up with some other things.
Yes, definitely. We want to just mention our guests that were coming up. We have some great guests coming up. We have Jason Plourde, who is going to be talking to us about how to, the ultimate multitasker volunteer slash you name it, he does it.
Oh, he can be with me on Mother's Day and help out at the house.
So you're not going to want to miss that, talking to us about Scouts, soccer, Miramichi Ski Club, Sportsman's Club.
What a guy.
So if you're looking to do some volunteering, you're not going to want to miss Jason. We're going to be talking to him. Mm-hmm. And we also have Julie McCormick.
Great.
So don't go away. We're going to have some more Have a Chat right after these break. Hi, and welcome back to Have a Chat. I'm Audrey Lynch, and we've been chit-chatting with our quick chat portion of the show with Judy and I. Mm-hmm. And up next, we want to share a very special guest. Jason Plourde is with us.
Hi, Jason.
Thank you, Jason,
for joining us today.
Pleasure to have you.
Yes.
I was trying to think of a title to introduce you with, and besides, like, multitasker...
Superman
volunteer. I'm like, there's got to be a title that covers all of the things that you do.
There's not. There's really not. There's just volunteerism. I don't know how else to describe it. And when people say, where do you find time? Because we don't have time. I say, no, yes you do. Because I work 44 hours a week as a welder.
Okay.
So I'm full-time employed Monday to Friday. And then on top of that, I said I was a ski instructor in the winter months for the cross-country ski club, soccer coach in the summer months, and I run scouts all year round, and also youth facilitator for the Miramichi Sportsman Club, which deals in the safety and handling of firearms and
that's
such like that.
That's a huge agenda.
So if anyone says they don't have time, come see me.
Time management. It's all about time management.
I love it in the volunteer work. I volunteer steadily, and I know that there are things probably that I could be doing at home, like there's always going to be laundry, and there's going to be this and that. I'd rather give my time to serve somebody.
And they try to get me into the administrative parts of stuff, and I refused. I said, no, I'm about the youth. I want to interact with the youth and keep them busy. And
it's a wonderful thing.
There's enough people that want to stay behind the scenes.
Why didn't you
You're
have
more
the
hands-on. Hands-on.
Yeah, I'm more hands-on
a
guy.
Counselor.
Too busy with kids.
That's right. You have your plate full.
Yes.
Well, tell us a little bit more about you personally, who you are, in case there's anybody out there who just might not know.
A lot of people have seen me around with various organizations. I said, and previous, these are just my four top that I've recently am now still involved in. In the past, with Ducks Unlimited, I've been Big Brothers, Big Sisters a little bit for a short time. And you have to really pick and choose which programs are suffering. To me, I picked the ones that were suffering and kids benefit from
okay.
kind of thing. So I've been a lifelong resident of Miramichi. I haven't done the Out West thing yet.
Good.
I've been staying
haven't
here.
Haven't had to.
Love
no,
you.
I have a roof. I have food on my table. I'm good.
That's a great thing yeah. about a trade, isn't it?
Yes.
When you took your welding
yeah.
trade, you know there's always going to be work in that field.
Yeah. yeah. And that was just a recent thing, because for all my life I've been a laborer, and just at last year I went back to school. I got laid off as a laborer, and I said, I'm going to school. Trades are the way to go. So we
yes.
went into the
yeah.
trade, and...
Never looked back.
Never looked back.
Smart man.
Staying here as long as I can. Yes. Miramichi is the way to go.
Quite the uniform. Are we going to touch on this later about the Scouts?
We'll do
this
one.
Would you like to lead into all
okay.
of your volunteer work?
Yeah. First, I'd like to start with the ski club because it just ended.
I was going to say, we're just coming to the end. In case you missed
yep.
it, there is no snow.
There is no snow. So skiing is done now.
No offense.
Sorry.
So it's been running since 1980 in Miramichi, but it started back in 75 in Manitoba with the Jack Rabbit program. And these are kids ages 4 to, well, they teach adults now skiing.
Mm-hmm.
But
yes.
I primarily stick with the younger generations 4, 5, 6, and 7 and 8s,
mm-hmm.
and just very basic instructions on how to cross country ski. Now they supply the skis free of charge, so
very
there's no
nice.
Ski rental for the young kids.
Yeah.
So you don't have to go out and spend all this money on your new skis.
No.
And it's every Saturday morning or Saturday afternoons. We watch the temperature too.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Right. So we want the kids to be safe, and it's about an hour and a half of ski instruction, and they actually get out on the trails. And to make it fun for the kids, we usually put stuffed animals out on the trail. So watch for the owl today.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
And they're thinking real owl. Then they get out, and there's this big stuffed purple owl in the trail somewhere.
Fun.
And it makes it fun for them. So they go on and come back and see, what's he going to do this week? Because
right.
we know he's got something.
A rough winter, though,
yes.
snow-wise. Wasn't
it,
Jason?
Was.
A little
it
bit
was.
Dismal in that respect.
Yeah, and luckily enough, the kids' Saturday mornings were great this year.
Okay.
We had enough snow. We had the temperatures were just
good.
Prime for the kids.
Good.
The recreational skiing suffered a little bit, we still did
you
very well.
We
got through.
Next year might
next
be a better year for that snow.
Next one's coming.
So what do the parents do? Like, say I wanted to take, do I just drop them off to you, or do I ski as well, or how does that
yes.
go? I'm like, well, I'm the age that he was saying, I'm like, just drop them off and send them into the woods.
For the whole day, go look for owls. You're going to look for owls, kids. I'm going
yes.
shopping.
And this is the most common question, is what do I do when you're skiing? I said, well, you know what? We have an extra pair of skis. Come with us.
Oh, good idea.
Yeah.
But if the parents choose just to... Some of them want that little break, you know, I got to let my kid go on their own kind of thing. And
they
gather with other kids
sometimes
very well.
And are more willing to try and put themselves out there if the parent is not there.
It's true.
It is so true.
Yes.
So parents then have a choice to go skiing on their own while we're doing some instructions. And there's also snowshoe trails there also.
Right.
So they can try that.
Mm-hmm.
Or have a coffee and they'll stay in the lodge and have a coffee. And some parents volunteer to stay behind getting hot chocolate ready for the end of the ski lesson.
That is such a nice program. And you've had donations coming in to support your ski club, have you not?
Yes,
Which and is a necessity, really,
very
to keep
big
that
necessity.
Going.
Keep it up and running,
Yes. And right now we're trying to get the lodge revamped, because that lodge has been around for a while, so we wanted to modernize it a little bit.
Yeah.
It's a little better, so,
No, good on you. And then what else are you involved in?
So now what I'm... As I hung up my skis, now I'm bringing out the soccer cleats.
Okay. You organize with all that? You get room for all your gear?
I've actually have book bags. I just grabbed this bag.
Wow.
Blue one's my Scouts, red one's my soccer.
Okay.
And away
organized.
I go. We are organized that way. So soccer's about to start. Registration is, your early registration fee has already been passed.
Mm-hmm.
So now I can't quote me on the late fee, it's not very much more.
Okay.
So, but it runs from May until August.
Yes.
And it's every Tuesday and Thursday evenings.
Are you at the James M. Hill Field?
We're at the James M. Hill Field.
Mm-hmm. That's a huge enrollment you have for soccer.
That is. It's big.
Well, isn't it the number one sport in the world?
It is it's the most registered sport in Canada right now.
I think it's worldwide right up there at the top.
Yep, it's beat out hockey, and for $70 for
Well, the price
a week.
Is right.
The equipment
no
is
just
none.
No experience is necessary. The amount of equipment,
cleats. All we require is cleats or decent sneakers and shin guards, and that's for their protection. We supply the shorts, the socks, and the uniform.
Yeah, pretty darn good.
That's really good for 70
And so much fun. My kids were both in soccer when they were young. I socialized. Actually, what's a great idea for the moms and dads are if you're not just chit chatting, you can walk the track while the kids are playing soccer.
Yes, very much so. And a lot of the parents, we try to get them involved a little bit. With the younger kids, the 4-year-olds and the 6-year-olds, let mom and dad come out. Yeah. Kids, we're going to play against your parents.
Okay.
And the parents.
Fun.
Yeah, so we have little games like that set. I have now taken on the role of, they call it U8, which is 8 and under.
Mm-hmm.
So it's B's 6, 7, 8s. And these guys are amazing. This is the hyper group where they're not competitive yet, but they're eager to learn the skill and start becoming competitive. And I refuse to let my, each coach is different, so I can't speak for other coaches.
Yes.
My team, I focus on primarily fun and teamwork. Mm-hmm. Like, we're out here to have fun. I'm not keeping score, kids.
Right. That's a great element.
And they will tell you this. We won 6-8. And I said, I don't know.
You don't care? No. Is it co-ed, though?
Yes.
You say it's guys. Very, yeah, it's both boys and girls.
Until you get to a certain age.
To a certain age. Okay. Once you hit 10 and under, they split up. Mm, okay. And then on top of that, there's also competitive soccer. So once when they hit U8, I'll watch some of the kids, and if I see one that's constantly dominating, he's mm-hmm. beyond exceptional skill,
right.
I'll approach the competitive team and say, I got one kid for you, and they'll approach him and see if he's interested. And there's nothing's forced, like nothing's forced on
them. It's a great game. I love soccer. Do you have female coaches on the
yes.
field as well?
We have female and male coaches. And
didn't
realize
that.
It's always an issue getting coaches. We almost got to volunteer people to come. It's hard to get volunteers.
We'll spread the word. Anyone listening, Jason could certainly use a hand for coaches out there.
Yes. Yeah. And I know last year was one of my biggest things. Like someone said, why do you coach soccer? Like, what do you get out of it? And I said, well, here's just my one little story I tell everybody. And okay. I put this back on my Facebook every year when soccer registration comes around. This little young player was a female. Mm-hmm. Coach, I just scored my first goal. I've never scored a goal before. And I swear to goodness, she used to come out with a blanket or a teddy bear under her arm. And I'd let her, like, that was her comfort zone, let her go, right? She goes, what do I do? My legs are shaking. I'm not sure what to do. And I just started smiling. And I was like, I come up with something quick. Like, we got to encourage this kid. She's like just beaming here. And she's never spoke to anybody on the field, right? So I said, we celebrate. We high five. And I said, that leg shaking, that's just the excitement of accomplishing something you never knew you had.
Isn't that wonderful?
Yeah. And it was just like spur of the moment. And she's like, that's it.
That's
and she,
it.
She took off running and high fived the rest of the teammates.
Good.
And we
ran.
Good.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So we're going to move on.
Yes.
Make sure we don't run out of time. We have about
Scouts.
Yes.
Scouts is next. So Scouts run, basically, if your child is in school, whether it be kindergarten right to grade 12, they can join Scouts. There's age categories for everything. We have the Beavers. Which is, we involve them in the community. They're seeing the fire hall, they're seeing the ambulance buildings, they're doing the food banks, the coats for children. Really community activated.
Right.
And show, and that way. And they also do the Beaver Buggies. Which is
Beavers.
So we have our cub car races, so Beavers get to do the Beaver Buggies. So the Cubs is the next one, which is 8, 9, and 10s. And maybe it could be 7, 8, 9, 10. We move up to Cub Cars, and that's right. These guys. So they actually, we take them to high school. They cut out their own cars.
All the kids know this Minecraft. If you
know.
Haven't seen this.
Nice. Everybody knows. Into it. Hi, Trent.
What
I want that now.
Yep. Minecraft cars.
And this car actually went to Fredericton to the Provincials and came in fifth at a 39 cars.
Cool.
So
wow.
That was really...
Quite
that
the
was,
car.
That was an exceptional, like, this is really competitive.
That's a fun thing.
So that's Cubs.
Yep. This is
Beavers, Cubs. And
Cubs. Then we go into Scouts. And now my Cubs, they're basically... introduction to camping, introduction to knots, introduction to such. But I've got a full year for them. We're going to the Water Bombers. We're doing camps.
Oh, my.
2 years' time, we're going to Camp Roosevelt, which is in Maine. So we're starting to fundraise next year for that. And we have a Camp and Renews, which is for Scouts. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people don't know that it even exists.
Right.
And we've utilized it. And in June, we're heading to Fredericton to Camp Link Up, which is all the Beavers, Scouts, Cubs, Ventures come together and camp for a full weekend, and we'll break the troops up. So three of my guys from this group will go with St. John and Fredericton and Moncton and build a group.
Yes.
Three next guys will go, say, with Bathurst and Rogersville. So they get the inner...
They're not just with their own troop anymore. They mix up with the other troops from the other cities.
Yeah, so they get to exchange badges, they get to tell stories, and they got to work together.
How's your enrollment all told for these programs? Yep.
Okay, so skiing, we've... Oh my goodness.
Well, not for Scouts.
Yeah, for Scouts. Scouts. Okay, let's just stick with Scouts. Okay.
Scouts.
So far for Scouts this year, we have 40 enrolled at the moment.
Mm-hmm.
So that would put us at 18 Beavers.
Mm-hmm.
So 4, 5, and 6.
Nice little number.
Yep. We have 14 Cubs.
Good.
Which is 7, 8, 9.
Yeah.
And then Scouts, we only have 6. Now, we tend to lose our Scouts and Adventures to Air Cadets and Army Cadets.
Oh, nice.
Because that's when that's at 12 years old.
Yeah.
Parents are listening today. Parents maybe listen to the show and say, hey, that's something my child might be involved in as he's older now and doesn't know what quite to do with himself.
And some, when we had actually one scout that did both programs. He was with the Air Cadets and Scouts, and his biggest conflict was the weekends. He's like, you guys are going to Yoho, and Air Cadets are going to Halifax. He's like, I'm going to Yoho. We have so much more fun.
Yeah, yeah, it sounds like fun. Yeah. Were you a scout yourself? Did you go straight through the program
as
a child?
I started late in the program. I started in the 90s, and that was back when the RCMP was still in Newcastle on CI Road, and we had the RCMP Ventures. Now, that was 16, 17, and 18-year-olds.
Yes.
And they sponsored us, so we got to do the ride-alongs. We got to do, we facilitated ourselves just with the RCMP and did what they did, and we had a second troop, which strictly stayed with scouting. And they nicknamed themselves the Rebels.
The Rebels. That's our nickname, too.
Rebels, yes.
So this year, the group and the numbers that you're telling us, is this the Miramichi?
This is just the Miramichi. We only have one scouting group on the river.
Okay.
And we are co-ed also. Mm-hmm. So we do allow girls. However, Girl Guides on the River is really strong.
We have eight or nine troops.
Yeah. But we do have potential. I know there's two parents that approached me on race, and my girl doesn't want to really do guides. Or do you got room for scouts? We always have room.
You still call them scouts, the girls? Or scoutesses? Like countesses? Still... Counts and countesses. Scouts and scoutesses.
Yep. No, they're still scouts. They're still Beavers, Cub Scouts, and Ventures. So, and they changed the name of the leaders to scouters now. We're not, because we want the kids to be leaders.
Yes.
So we're implementing them leadership skills.
Very good.
And the program this year is changing yet again.
That was my next question, is how's the program compared to what it was when we were younger?
Yes.
Like what you teach the kids and what you show the kids, I would imagine it's always evolving.
It's always different. So just for instance, I'm going to speak with Cubs because that's my area of expertise. Okay. They had 63 badges to acquire in 3 years' time. Like, they can work up to 63 badges.
That's a lot.
So it would cover their sleeve, right?
Yeah, cover their body.
Yep. So now this year what they have done is starting in August, we have the Canadian Path. So it's strictly focusing on Canadian history. So we do a lot of storytelling about the War of 18, Normandy and such like that. We have little games designed for it. Chase the Hearts, where the Newfoundland Regiment went out and... We'll put four hearts out in the field in the envelopes, and the rest of the playing cards will be out there. They got to go gather envelopes, and they come back, and whoever have hearts were the survivors. And that just shows them how many Newfoundlands had passed away during the war.
Very educational.
Yeah. And we made it fun and still got the educational part.
You're right.
Well, but it'll stay with them when you do it that way, too.
Mm-hmm. So now, instead of the 63 badges on our arms, we now have implemented a program where they have 9 badges. Now, 9 works from Beavers right to Ventures. And with each badge, there's 9 levels.
Okay.
So we still got our levels.
Yeah.
So now with the Beaver, say for canoeing level 1, if he can do one stroke, he gets level 1. That will carry up through up to Ventures.
Right.
So you're not ripping badges off and getting a new bag. Or essentially such
you
Beavers.
You build on as opposed to replace.
Yes. So when Cubs used to move to Scouts, they'd have to start from scratch again with a new program. I got to do my knot tying again, got to do this again. Now it carries on. Now I'm at level 3, I can go to level 4. And it's age appropriate, right?
Exactly.
So anybody that's coming into my Cub program, for instance, if you were swimming and you're level 4 swimming, you're not going to start at level 1 on my aquatics program.
No.
We're going to give you a badge 4.
Do you do the campfire stuff where you learn to start fires and pop tents?
We still do the old school stuff.
I like that. I think that's really so important. You can teach me something about that.
Yes. And this year we took my Cubs, 14 brand new Cubs who were first time going camping. And as a leaders and Cubs, we only went for one night as a test.
Okay. Test run.
Test run to see how leaders were going to handle it and how the kids were going to handle it. And I laughed because one child brought a suitcase full of toys. Because I told them right in the beginning, no electronics. And they're like, what?
No iPads? In this world, this
day and age, it'd be a lot harder.
Yep. I said, well, you got no cell phone service where we're going, so there's no sense.
Right. Put it all away.
Put this your game away. So he brought a suitcase literally of dinky cars, toys, Minecraft things.
Funny.
We went in Saturday afternoon at lunchtime, and we came out Sunday at lunchtime, and he said, Mom, I didn't even open my suitcase. They had us doing so much stuff.
Go on.
Very worthwhile tasks.
Much so.
I mean, those are life skills. If you're stuck out there and you have to, you know how to keep warm.
Survival skills.
Survival skills are very important for anybody.
And Cubs were learning very, very basics. Starting fires with adult supervision, and we highly pump this into their head, like, don't be doing this on your own.
No, never.
And this is, so when your family's going camping, tell your dad you can start the fire.
Yeah, have them watching over you.
Yep. And they build those skills, right? So, and we always let them, I always take one kid and said, you're going to run the program. And they're like, what? I said, this is what I want you to build. I'll show you how to build it. You got to teach the rest.
Nice.
And so the leaders are no longer doing everything for them. Mm-hmm. We're letting them do and letting them pass on. So I'll take my third year cubs, teach my second year teaches my first year. Kind of thing.
You must get a lot of reward stories coming back to you, Jason. Oh,
we have so much fun.
I love that.
Yes. Well, I want to let our viewers know before we're all done with Jason, how do they get a hold of you if they are interested in this program?
We meet every Monday night at Gretna Green.
Gretna Green.
Yes, okay. The Gretna Green School. However, the school's being renovated right now.
Oh, right.
So we're on the road. So we're going some water bomber visitations. We're doing fishing. So the best way, everyone's on Facebook nowadays. So we First Gretna Green
Gretna Green Scouting. So you can find you on Facebook.
Definitely on Facebook.
Thank you so much, Jason, for joining us.
Yes.
Don't go away. We'll be back with more. Have a Chat. Good afternoon and welcome back to Have a Chat. We just had a great guest with us. Jason Plourde was talking to us about all the different things that he volunteers with. Number one, big one, scouting.
Interesting guy.
Yes,
lots
definitely.
To learn from him.
Check him out on Facebook if you're interested or want more information concerning that program. Mm-hmm. Up next, we have a wonderful lady joining us, Julie McCormick, who is here to talk to us today, who volunteers as well, about the roof that Jack started.
Hello, Julie.
Hello, darling.
We finally got you on.
Yes.
Busy girl, hard to book, but we made it.
That's okay.
Tell us a little bit about yourself, Julie, in case there's anybody out there who doesn't know you.
Oh,
I highly doubt that.
That'd be probably. Of course, I'm Julie McCormick. Born and bred in Napan. Daughter of Alan and Helen Gillis of Napan. I won't say my age. I always tell everybody I'm 21, so that's how much I feel.
That's how far gone I am.
Thank you, Judy. my husband and I host international students from other countries. Right now we're on our 14th student.
Oh, wow.
He's from Colombia. So we've hosted from Mexico, Korea, China, and now Colombia.
How interesting. And what wonderful people to do that.
Yeah, and their families are awesome, too. We work with a program called AEI. And we love it. So it's other than that, I volunteer with the Napan Agricultural Show, so we'll get into that more in a moment.
For a long time.
Yeah,
I'm
busy.
Exactly. That's just it. But today we're here to mainly talk about the roof that Jack started. Now, some of our viewers may have heard of this because this has gone on for a few years now, isn't it?
Yep.
So this would be the...
Well, we're on the... It was 2012 when Jack Walsh passed away. Mm-hmm. And... his family asked for the memorial donations to go to the Napan Agricultural Show. Mm-hmm. So the roof that Jack started is a committee off of the Napan Agricultural Show.
Okay.
Everyone that's involved is a volunteer with the Napan Agricultural Show. So when he passed away in 2012, the family asked for the memorial donations to go to the fair. So the Napan Agricultural Show was like, okay, we just don't want to put the money that came to us into the next year's show. So what can we do with it? When Jack was a director with us years ago, and he was a very good volunteer, like he was very dedicated, he always wanted a roof over the ring because, of course, everybody knows when it rained, you bring your rain jacket and rubber boots or you're in trouble.
That's right. Exactly.
So what he, we had a committee, they decided and they said, let's look at first of all, putting a roof over the ring we had. When the building committee, looked into everything, it was going to be too close to the Napan Agricultural Show. Mm-hmm. The Napan Hall.
Okay, that building, that structure.
Yep, and the structure of the ring was going to, we were going to have to change it anyways. Because everything wasn't. So the committee looked into a new arena. So it was actually going to be cheaper to do a new arena with a roof on it in behind the old arena, as opposed to putting a roof and changing everything. Yep. So that is what we're in process now. Mm-hmm. We are looking at, we have to raise $100,000 ourselves, $100,000 ourselves. We are at 63.
Good
so
for you.
So we're very close. Yeah,
that's
since 2012.
Really, that's
fabulous. So it is. The committee has done very well. Very dedicated bunch, and I'll tell you who's on the committee.
Yeah, I was going to ask you who was on that.
I forget where I was going.
We'll just jump right into the committee. So just perfect. Tell us a little bit who you're involved with for this whole big enterprise.
So the Napan Agricultural Show is built or made up. It's non-profitable, obviously. Mm-hmm. 26 directors. Yes.
Huge.
I will not name them all because I know I will miss some as I go, mm-hmm. but I could put you in contact with any one of them if you wanted to become a volunteer as well,
okay.
under a director. So this year I chose to be a volunteer under two directors as opposed to being a director.
Mm-hmm.
So this way here I spread myself
yes.
and I'm not, because each director has their job to do.
Right.
Okay. So let's pretend entertainment. Okay,
right.
I will pick on her because my sister Melanie. We can say Melanie. We can pick her up. So she's also the president. Melanie Gillis-Buckty is the president. She's in charge of the entertainment, bringing the entertainment into the fair. So she has to work on that, and by a certain date, the guy who makes up the schedules, he would like to know who's coming to allow slots.
Mm-hmm.
So that's her job. So each director has their own main focus, and like I said, 26. And they put the show together.
So just specifically for entertainment, what would be some of the things that you could anticipate?
Well, this year is, they're looking at four teams of oxen for an oxen pull.
Ooh.
Do you know what an oxen pull is?
Oh, yes, I've pulled them many times in my life. That's my favorite thing to do
is
to pull oxen. That's the muscles.
That's what I thought. The oxen is a type of cattle, of course.
Yes.
Right. And they are going to do like the horse haul, like the horse haulers
cool.
do, but this is going to be oxen. So that's one of the main
That's
attractions.
Gonna be cool.
She is working on a couple of others.
Yeah.
But the bouncy castles will be back with the kids. So a lot of people say, why don't you have rides? Why don't you have rides at the fair?
Yeah. They did that before,
yes.
right?
There was a small little fair there.
The reason is we try to stick to our motto. Mm-hmm. And our motto is to promote agriculture and community living in the general public.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So we want to promote agriculture as opposed to being an exhibition.
Sure.
Okay. Right. So maybe we'll go back to the roof that Jack started, because that's mm-hmm.
yeah.
the committee. So with all our directors, we do have several committees throughout the building committee. And this roof that Jack started, the director to this, the fundraising director is April Dixon.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
But then we have another committee with the roof that Jack started, which is my father, Alan Gillis. He is the director to that. I'm on a committee with him. Darlene O'Donnell, Garth Sweezy, June Dixon, April Alan and Jeffrey Gillis.
What a great group. I know them all.
Yeah.
Very dynamic
So
bunch.
What we have coming up is we have a fundraiser coming up. The proceeds are going to the roof that Jack started. It's Saturday, May 14th
mm-hmm.
At 5:30 p.m. Tickets are on sale. Advance. Oh, thanks.
Yeah.
Advance.
You go ahead.
I'm writing it down just in case I don't have a poster.
Well, I can give you mine when I
Okay.
Friday.
Perfect.
Advance tickets only. I would like to know by this weekend. I'd like people to purchase their tickets by this weekend. It's $25
mm-hmm.
by calling me at 778-9449. Just don't anyone call me now. That's my phone number.
Okay.
Leave a message. I can meet up. That's okay. Meet up with you and we can get some tickets. We have a guest speaker. Yep. Terry Steves. He's the president of the Albert County Exhibition. Mm-hmm. And the reason we have him coming mm-hmm. is that they just did a new arena with a roof.
There you go.
So he's going to tell us what to expect and what the process was. And I must say, after our 100 grand, we have other people, government-wise, stepping in to help. So you have to go through all the steps.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if somebody out there has lots of money or committed to some money and want to help us out, donate,
yes.
we can certainly maybe even make a deal somehow. So
looking on this, is a beautiful hot turkey dinner.
The full
yes.
trimmings,
yum.
Salad, the turkey with the trimmings,
nice.
Strawberry shortcake for dessert, tea, coffee.
How much are tickets, Julie?
$25 a person.
$25.
Yeah, so it's very
for
cheap
dinner.
For a night of entertainment.
Mm-hmm.
We also will be having five members being recognized for their community service. Helen and Johnny McDermott.
Awesome. Love them.
Yeah. Roy and Anita Gillis.
Okay, I know
they,
him.
Yep. And Barb Hondas.
Oh, my.
Now,
oh, yes.
Barb has stuck by us with the Napan School, so she will be
one of
there
as guests?
Well. So those people will be recognized.
They deserve to be recognized.
Yes.
Hard
and
workers.
I get the honor of introducing Johnny and Helen.
He's so funny. I'd love to be there. I want to be there just to hear him.
Well, come on. I'm telling you.
Oh, he's so cute.
It was the best hour and a half of my life to interview them. So that's the way that goes.
So the Napan Community Center is having this beautiful fundraiser dinner to promote Roof the Jack started Saturday, May 14th at the Napan Community Center.
Okay. Yes, yeah, so feel free to give me a call. We also have how to get a hold of me.
Yeah, we want to mention that you can email show@napan.com, and they have a website, napan.ca/show, and also on Facebook, Napan Agricultural Show
or
The Roof That Jack Started. Yep. And then you can call. They've got a couple of numbers. Julie's number, of course, 778-9449, and Alan Gillis, which
father.
Is 773-6204. Okay. So email, website, Facebook, and phone numbers, all.
Now, we've had several past fundraisers that we've done. Just an example, right now we're just finishing up a lotto that we did. It was a lotto.
Okay.
It was $10 for 10 numbers. This is going to stop, and we are going, I'll get into something new here in a second.
Mm-hmm.
We've had truck pulls. Last year we had the RCMP musical ride.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
That was awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yeah.
We do 50-50s at the shows. We had poker rallies, bake sales, and past suppers. There's lots of stuff turning in my head of things, more things that we'd like to do.
Mm-hmm.
We have a meeting tonight, and there was a wonderful dance on the weekend in Logieville Hall.
Ooh,
with
yes.
Short Street Rides.
Oh, they're awesome.
That is something that I'd like to do as well. The new fundraiser that we have coming up, people are going to probably think we're a little nuts, but we're going to do Cut the Jack of Hearts, where Jack Walsh was his heart.
I didn't know Jack Walsh. I feel like I missed out on a really great person.
Do you know Ruth Logie?
No.
Okay. That would be her brother.
I know
brother.
Everybody else. That's what the only people I didn't know.
Billy Noy Walsh?
Yes,
okay,
yes.
That would be their brother.
Okay.
He was super and very, he even took his vacation after he moved away, because when the CFP closed down, he moved away. And he took his vacation to come home and be our ringmaster and everything.
Dedicated.
So, as when he left, he was still with us. So we're going to start the contest, Cut the Jack of Hearts. And I understand there's two others on the energy. We're going to make it a little unique, because we're going to have tea and coffee at the Napan Hall on Friday nights. There will be something to eat. So stay tuned to our Facebook page. Okay. Feel free to call me.
Mm-hmm.
And we are going to get into some entertainment on Friday nights, too. So as we get going, it will be an evening.
I just can't do that.
Yes, you can.
I don't think.
Karaoke.
I don't think.
Karaoke. She's karaoke. All about that.
Karaoke.
Do karaoke and she'll be there.
Stay tuned to our Facebook page. You will be able to buy advance tickets. Email us. But you'll be able to buy advance tickets from, we're going to start it on May 20th. Mm. On May 19th, we will start selling tickets at the City Limits. They are going to...
Out in the highway.
Yes, they're going to have us there, and we'll sell. It'll be from 4... just a second, they changed the time on me tonight there. So Friday night, 7 o'clock will be the draws. At 5... What did they tell me? Oh, 5 to 6:45,
mm-hmm.
we'll be at the Napan Hall.
You
can
come
by.
You have to be there to win.
No.
No?
No way.
Okay.
Yeah. You can e-transfer me money, and we will, for that $10, see, there's always a way.
Those eyes lighten up.
Yes. I will get your name onto tickets and get it into the drum
that
night. So we're guaranteed prize of $2,000 to start right off with. We've had a generous donation from somebody in the community that's going to start us right off there.
Oh, wow.
So if you cut it the first night, you automatically get the money. So
it's possible that, I don't play the other two as of yet. I don't quite understand the game.
Okay,
we have time? We have time to explain
Okay, quickly.
How's it go?
Okay, so you have a deck of cards, okay?
Okay.
And
there's only 52 in the deck.
Right, so it may take us 52 weeks.
Okay.
It will.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm starting to get it now.
Yeah.
So
you buy your tickets. Your tickets go in the drum. We twirl the drum.
And they're like a number.
Yeah, it's just the normal tickets.
Okay.
Okay. So if you're there and you have your ticket, you can come up. But if you buy them in advance, your name will be written on the back of that ticket that goes in the drum.
Okay.
Okay.
And so does someone cut the cards for me?
Yeah. Well, once the ticket's drawn, we either says Audrey Lynch, or you have the ticket if you're there.
Okay.
Okay. If you're not there, there will be a designated person to draw
a card
for you.
Draw
if you're there, of course, cut the deck. Cut it. You can take whatever card you want out of there.
Okay.
If you flip over the Jack of Hearts, you will win the
2,000.
2,000 plus the 2,000. Sorry, that'll be the guaranteed
yes.
prize. But the 20% made that night
okay,
will go to you two. The 30% goes to next week, and the 50% goes into the roof.
Oh, cool. They've got it all worked out. And cost of tickets are 2 for $1, 3 for $5, and 10 for $10.
That's the going rate. And you must be 19.
I can't play then.
Next year.
How many cards do you pick that night? Or how many tickets do you draw? It's just one.
One draw.
Just one.
Yep.
And it could take up to 52 weeks.
Right.
You can be busy for a lot of Fridays.
I know.
It is a commitment, but hey.
And it's $10
a ticket? Hand over your $100 and I'll get you in for 10 weeks.
That's really true. You can buy them.
But there's great, like I say, there's going to be tea and coffee, so it will be kind of a social evening as well. We're going to make it a social evening. So you guys are first to find out, by the way.
And I love our mugs. Julie brought us each a beautiful mug. Napan Agricultural Show. Yeah. Lovely design. I'm proud of it. I drink my coffee every morning. Yeah. So it'll remind me of all these events happening.
This is a new design, is it?
I'm going to take a guess, and I'm probably maybe. We put it years ago when the Napan Agricultural started. This is our 25th anniversary will be this year. We put a... Before that, it was Napan Days, which went from a horse haul to a supper,
right?
Then into pet shows and horse shows, then on to the Napan Agricultural Show. So this year will be our 25th anniversary, and this design was put out to the Napan School at one time as a contest, contest.
Yeah.
What the child? Now I'm not going to say who it was because I'm really not sure. They designed something, then we gave it to somebody, and they kind of fixed it up.
Okay, so yep. Fine-tuned it.
There's a spade and a hoe, and people
that's
can't...
That's a fork,
That's
Judy.
A fork?
Not
I can't... Okay, that...
This
I
is a spade.
I never did farm.
Okay.
Then I probably never
Why
will.
Why don't you come back sometime?
I'll be doing the oxen pull this year. I just have to go to the gym for a few weeks prior to that and bulk up a little bit.
You're not pulling the oxen, Judy. No, but... The oxen's going to pull the weight.
I know. I want to be part of that whole event.
Okay. The show's dates this year is August 14th.
August
11 to 14.
August 11 to the 14th. Okay.
We are, the directors are working hard. Mm-hmm. We could not do it without the sponsors and volunteers. Okay. The sponsors, my dad and I go around to the sponsors, and we, it's between $10,000 and $15,000 that sponsors donate every year.
It's amazing.
Businesses throughout Miramichi. Miramichi is a big supporter of us in Napan. So we use them and the volunteers, of course. We cannot do anything without a volunteer. So if you know anybody that would like to volunteer or get involved with us, you do not have to be from Napan. We do have people from outside the city involved, and everybody works together. If you don't understand what your job is going to do, someone will help you get into that until you get more comfortable.
Imagine having 26 directors.
No,
I've sat in many boards of directors. We might have had 8.
Well, would you like to add another committee to your...
let me back you.
Yes. Well, to wrap things up, I want to say you said $63,000 is what you've raised so far.
Yes.
And so you don't have far to go.
No, we don't have far to go.
So $100,000 is where you're looking to get to. So.
And then we'll... But unless, like I said...
And you can get started on it.
Yes. Everything, the prints are done. The prints, everything's ready. During this night of the fundraiser, everything will be spoken by the building committee of what's going to go on. And
it's awesome again.
Yes.
Yeah. So Saturday, May 14th, 5:30, Napan That's Community the Center. Yep. And the fundraiser, the proceeds are going to the roof that Jack started.
Yep.
And tell them where you get the tickets again.
For me, 778-9449. Or you can do email, website, or whatever.
Thanks so much, Julie.
No problem.
Looking forward to this.
Thanks for joining us here at Have a Chat. We'll see you again next week. Thanks for joining us. Bye.